through a cylinder. Now here we are having a cylinder of inner radius R1, outer radius R2. The temperature at the inside of the cylinder is T1 and at the outside it is T2, and the length of the cylinder is L. Now we are having a cylinder in such a way that the heat is passing in the axial direction. That means there is now heat is passing in the radial direction. There is no movement, no heat transfer in the axial direction. Heat transfer in the radial direction. Now by simple heat equation, Q is equal to KA dT by dr, where K is the thermal conductivity, A is the area of this cross section, or area through which heat flows. Now, dT by dr is temperature gradient. Now Q is the heat. Now here, for studying it, we are considering an arbitrary circle at a radius R. And now we are considering another circle which is at a distance dr from the previous circle. That is, this distance is dr. So here, when we are looking from here, the first circle will be somewhat like this R. So heat will be passing like this in the radial direction. Now, so if we are extending this one, this will be somewhat like this. So this will be of length L. That means the area, if we are considering this particular cylinder of radius small r, the heat will be passing through this area, the curved surface area of this small cylinder. And that curved surface area, or the area through which the heat passes, that is equal to 2 into pi into r into length. So that is the area through which heat passes, that is this A area. Now this is the dr length. And let the temperature difference between these two circles be dT. Then applying here, K is equal to Q is equal to minus KA dT by dr. But we know A is equal to 2 pi R L dT by dr. Now what we do is we are taking this R and dr on the other side. So Q into dr by dr, that is equal to minus K 2 pi into dt. 2 pi L into dt. Now integrating from R1 to R2. So that is from T1 to T2. So we have a Q log R2 by R1 is equal to minus K 2 pi L, which are constant here. So that is equal to T2 minus T1. So T2 minus T1. Taking this negative inside, we have that is equal to T1 minus T2. So we have Q is equal to log R2 by R1 minus K2 pi L T2 minus T1. Now we can rearrange like this. Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by Q. No, not Q, Q we are placing that there. Log R2 by R1. Then we are taking this here, K by 2 pi L. So this is like I is equal to V by R. So V means T1 minus T2, the temperature difference, that is the potential there. Q is similar to I. So we have this thermal resistance because of this cylinder, that is equal to log R2 by R1 by K2 pi L. So this equation gives the thermal resistance of this particular cylinder. As I said about heat conduction through a cylinder, hollow cylinder. Thank you.